Hello and welcome. Today we will be taking a bit of a look on the ARVN weapons, and I have created a game with bots for the opportunity. Now we could be a commander, but we're not going to be that. We're going to be a rifleman, and we're going to pick up the M1 Garand rifle. And that'll be our first tool for today. Now the reason I'm using bots is obvious, partially because on multiplayer servers, playing ARVN is quite difficult, and second of all, they aren't actually online when I'm recording this. So I basically just decided that no, I'm going with bots, and I'm gonna try and use as many of the ARVN weapons as possible while talking a bit about them. So I think it's not the M1 Garand is a decent battle rifle. It's semi-automatic. Fully comparable to the SKS and similar weapons. It has a really huge disadvantage in that it's very easy to just empty it and then realize you can't reload in the middle of a clip. And this is a really big issue. On the other hand, it's a very hard-hitting and accurate weapon. So as long as you keep tabs on how many rounds you actually use and doesn't overdo it with the suppressive fire, the M1 Garand is actually one of the better options in the ARVN arsenal. I know it's kind of heresy to say this, but part of me prefers it over... Yeah, that's the stuff that can happen with the M1 Garand. As you noticed, I ran out of ammo in the middle of a firefight. I didn't have time to aim. It's by no means a close quarters weapon. So we're gonna respawn and we're gonna keep trying to hold point B and see if we... Or point A, depending on what we're feeling up to. But I'm gonna go at least one more round with the M1 Garand. And some of you might wonder why this video is not me just massacring bots, and that is, I would like it to be. But the bots aren't really lining up the way they used to. So instead... In fact, the bots seem to have been somewhat improved with an ability to actually hide in the rather dark territories up ahead. But we're gonna take some terrain, and I think that's an enemy. Could be an enemy. Target identification. Yeah, it was an enemy. Target identification is not always easy. There we go. Got another one, I think. Reloading the Garand is sometimes a bit of a tricky thing to do. You'll have to remember that you do, in most cases, have a sidearm. And you need to be aware that this sidearm may be put to good use, especially in close quarters. Since the sidearm also takes a shorter time to reload. Like I said, the Garand packs the bigger punch. But the reload's a bit slow, and you can't reload it on the fly, meaning you might actually have to waste some bullets just to reload in the middle of a fight. I don't know why I didn't hit the guy there, but we need to take cover. Get down. We need to hit the deck. Hit the deck, refill, and see where the fuck the enemy support gunner's at. So, the enemy is running out of time, meaning they are having a big problem trying to actually take the checkpoint. That's not really really surprising, since defensive fire on this map can be really, really a pain in the butt. So I'm gonna stay low, and I don't know how many clips I actually got left for the Garand, but we should stay low regardless. The enemy should hopefully be able to break through, but I think hopefully, because this game should really last a bit longer. And we got killed. Not surprising. However, this is a good time for me to change to the M2 carbine. The M2 carbine is a light weapon, as far as I remember, it fires the pistol carbine. And unlike the M1 version, this one is fully automatic and magazine fed. So it's a huge improvement, and it's a shorter range weapon. It's not really a submachine gun per se, but it's a weapon that does well in shorter ranges. So we're gonna advance to a position close to B and see if we can't find some enemy. Yeah, as you can see, the situation where the Garand failed us, the M2 excels at. Short range, fully automatic burst, right into the face, boom. I don't know if they actually have respawns left, and if they don't have respawns left, we might have to go hunting for them. Okay, so I don't know where they are. We'll rush to second building. See if we can't peekaboo. Looks like enemy marks
that.
Crap! We're taking heavy enemy fire. I don't really even know where it's coming from, but we were only wounded in the leg, so we're gonna bandage that.
Return to combat.
And
return to combat.
The enemy doesn't like us being here. I gotta see about staying down and see if we. As you can see, it's a bit more ineffective on longer ranges, but it can work still. It's a very good weapon when you need something that's not really a machine gun, something that can actually be used at intermediate ranges as well. However, the big drawback is that the automatic fire of the M2 really drains your ammunition. I mean, really drains it. Tango down. Yeah, we got another one over there, I think. Nah, that's not an enemy. But it can kill in one shot. So we did that pretty nicely. So we should probably try and stay down. But I'm not gonna do that. Instead, I'm gonna go. Oh, crap. So, it's not really that much time left, so I'm just going to keep on letting the game run to a close and run around with the M2 carbine. But I think we got this. Unless the enemy actually takes one of the objectives, we are not in that much of danger. The 30 seconds remaining. Like I said, this map needs attackers knows what they're doing, and the bots ain't that. But we're taking fire, unclear from exactly what angle, but we're gonna take up a position in this bunker, see if we can't. One down.
Area is secure.
Victory! And that's the M1 Garand and the M2 Carbine. So we are going to see if we can't change teams now, because I think it's going to be a I think it's gonna be a team switch, so we are going to select team and we're gonna switch to the Republic of Vietnam. And the point man has the Thompson, and we were actually going to switch to the Thompson for this round. And I'm just gonna check so everything is in order and we are good to go. There we go. We are gonna move up on A and we're gonna defend A as quickly as possible. And let's see if the bots can do a better job with defending the village this time around. Ah, crap. Incoming RPGs. I'm gonna take cover in this hut. And I'm gonna use the hut and see if we can't... The M2 carbine has a very nice automatic fire and a nice punch to it. The Thompson is a submachine gun, so of course you would expect it to be more adept at range and stuff like that. And of course it feels better, but I'm also trying to keep an eye out if there are where the enemy might be coming from. Now, of course, they're throwing a lot of smoke grenades on A. Like, oh wait, there's one. The Thompson has a... arguably reduced recoil, and it also has more ammunition per mag than the M carbine. And it's a very nice experience, really, because it doesn't really have the same punch of a rifle. We actually got a kill there at 87 meters, which is quite a feat for a submachine gun. And, I mean, it's up there in the maximum engagement radius for such a weapon. So we're gonna jump down and we're gonna be trying to play a bit more aggressively with this game. And I'm gonna go up to the rocks here. I'm gonna switch weapon once I die, so I feel I have adequately presented the capabilities of the Thompson. So, crap. We had a submachine gun, but it didn't actually work. And I see it as fate wanting me to show you the Browning 1919 machine gun. Now, this is an absolute beast. This gun is one of the best, easily one of the best weapons in the game, and also one of the more fun ones to use. So, this is not a weapon that you run around with. You can run around with it, and that's part of the fun. I mean, you can do like this, and you can aim, and you can unleash absolute mayhem, but the thing is, you don't have that much of a reload to the weapon. I mean, what you have is what you have. It's not going to be automatically refilled for you. And like I said, there's basically no reloads going on here. So we're gonna set up a position here. Oh crap, that was not my intention. And we actually folded the bipods. It's a nice little thing that we can fold the bipods as well, but I'm actually going to extend them and try to use them. So, on a bipod like this is where this weapon really excels. Especially on a map like this where there's a lot of covers where you can use it. So, the enemy's actually attacking B. They're about to actually take it from us. And our squad leader have called in an artillery strike. We actually managed, just by sheer firing into the woods, get a kill. And we are gonna... Ah, crap. We're actually gonna spawn on X-ray, see if we can help defend B. And see if that is gonna work out for us. B is actually falling to the enemy. Of course, B falling to the enemy is not a good thing. I wanted the bots to do well, but I don't want them to do so well that they make me look bad. So we're gonna jump up on this helicopter pad, and we're gonna see if the 1919 machine gun can turn the tide. We got one kill. There's another one. Now hopefully this supporting... this fire support will be enough for our allies to retake the initiative and take the point. This is not the optimal way to use a machine gun, but as you can see, in a supported position, I am really laying down the hurt upon the North Vietnamese here.
We are taking Bravo.
And under the covering fire, our own forces are retaking.
AC-47 inbound. Take cover.
Oh crap, we actually got fire support from a spooky gunship. That's nice. We got a number of nice kills there. Move up. Let's see if... yeah, the AC gunship support is actually off. Firing off the map. It's been ordered in another region. So I think I've been... I like to think I've been able to show you what the this machine gun can do. So we're gonna fold the bipods and we're gonna switch to another, to the last weapon on our list. At least what I've, if I remember correctly, is going to be the last weapon on our list. I'm just gonna try and find someone that's willing to actually shoot at me. Because right now I can't find an enemy soldier. That's kind of interesting. I mean, you would think that there would be a lot of enemy soldiers around here. But there actually is not. Maybe we kill them all. Maybe they're all away on A. Maybe they're all where the gunship is currently firing. I don't know why the game suddenly just decided to lag out. But I really like the fact that first they failed to take B and now they're moving towards A. It gives me the feeling that the bots are actually coordinating their movements, and if so, that's a big step up for their intelligence. This is what happens if you basically fires the 1919 freehand. So, I'm just gonna double check. Yeah, there's the M1D sniper rifle. But I'm not really sure I'm going to show it to you. And the reason I'm not going to show that to you is because I feel it's a little bit too similar to the regular M1. But I'm not going to say, never going to say never. It all comes down to how the M1 bar actually feels. And like I said, I don't really know why the game just decided to be super slow. But we are gonna advance on A, and we're gonna jump down, and we are going to be on. Now, of course, the bar have two modes. Fast fire drains your ammunition supply really quickly. And then we have slow fire. Like I said, I have no idea why my game decided to just be this slow, but hopefully I can play well regardless. At any rate, the bar is more versatile than the 1919, but it also has the problem of very low ammunition count. I mean, it's 20 rounds per magazine, you have many magazines, so... with this gun, you better just learn to love the reloads. It's not a weapon of suppression. It's a weapon of accurately engaging on a distance. I mean, it's not a submachine gun. It's not an assault rifle. It's an infantry automatic rifle, and that means you engage the enemy and. Just make sure they either put their heads down or die. The bar can effectively be fired from the hip. But it's not really the way I would use the weapon. I would use it with bipods. But we are gonna fold the bipods for a second here. Check the house so we don't get shot from. But as you can see, it's a perfectly suitable weapon to use even without the bipods. But even with the fire selector on slow mode, you are really wasting ammo. I mean, it's basically fire, reload, and fire again with this weapon. But that's part of what makes it so interesting. It's a very versatile weapon. The ammunition is basically its only drawback. That's our people. So we're gonna deploy here, and I'm actually gonna keep playing until I die, and then we'll check out the marksmanship rifle.
Napalm inbound. Take cover.
This is also a nice feature. I mean, we have the gun supported on the table, and yeah, it looks like we actually retook A. So napalm support incoming. I can't see what deploys in napalm or where it was deployed, but oh crap. Covering fire! We are bleeding to death. It looked like we got shot in the gut. So we are currently bandaging it to try and handle the wound. And we are done. So I'm going to... And we got killed by mine. Alright, so last one. Marksman with the M1D Garen rifle. The M1 Garand D's marksmanship rifle is a bit interesting because its scopes is on the side, and the reason it is because of course the way you feed the weapon is in the middle, so you can't just place a scope right above it. There is a reason the M1903 Springfield was used as a sniper rifle for so long, and that was because a lot of people just did not want to have the hassle of it. So, we're gonna see... Oh crap, down on the ground. I think that might... I was gonna say that might be an enemy there, and sure enough, it was an enemy. But the problem with that being an enemy was, of course, that he shot us before I could show off my brilliant sniper killstreak skills. I mean, I'm basically playing against the bots here, and I'm getting my ass kicked. So we're going to B, and or at least going close to B, and my intention is to try and fire this weapon against the enemy. Hopefully without dying in the process. Of course, I'm moving very much into the open, so dying is... Yeah, Bravo is under attack, so we're gonna see if we can't put some rounds downrange. I'm gonna advance to the bunker straight ahead of me. I don't really have a machine gun here, so staying out of sight and picking off the enemy as they come will be the... Tango down. And of course, this weapon has basically the same drawback as the regular Garand. That is, you can't reload it. Or rather, if you seek to reload it, you have to waste your ammo first. And that's not a good thing. The enemy just captured the airfield, so we're gonna return there, and the game just slowed down again. I think part of the reason is because I have a lingering problem with... I don't know what the hell it is, but I'm getting an error message at launch, and this... I'm pretty much running this in a windowed mode that's... So, this was a good spot before. I'm gonna see if it's one again. Tango down. I think he might actually... No, he's dead. So we are gonna retake the airfield. Of course, the scope in the game is not side shooting, so you don't have to adjust for how the bullet's going to be. Where you're aiming is gonna be where you're hitting. And I'm both thankful and a bit disappointed about this, because it would have been a very interesting feature to try and remember that with this weapon, you have to shoot to the side. So I'm gonna move into B and try and help retake it. Of course, you have your trusty sidearm, but we're not gonna use that. We're gonna take this back, and once there, yeah, now it's fixed itself again. I wonder why. It might also be the fact I'm running 64 bots on this server. There's one. Everyone who runs is a VC. There's another VC. What actually this gun excels at is that... Yeah, and that's gonna be enough for now. But what the marksmanship rifle actually excels at is that... it can also easily be used as a battle rifle. And I like that. I mean, it's a very nice feature to have in a weapon like that. You are not restricted to the marksmanship role, but you can help out you guys on the line. Of course, you should still, you know, aim for the priority targets and stuff like that, but... At any rate, this has been the ARVN Weapons of Rising Storm 2. So, I hope that you check out Rising Storm 2, because it's quite a neat game. It's basically a mix between, say, Battlefield and Squad. I would say it puts itself squarely in the middle of those two games. With an interesting squad mechanic, it's semi-realistic, but it's not as realistic as to be difficult to play, even if you are alone. So, give it a look, and it's usually worth it to pick up on sale. So, catch you guys later.